Yes, children, let's continue with direct indirect speech. Already I told you what is the reporting verb, what is reported speech, and the basic norms. Yes, Vivan. Now we'll be doing change of tenses, present indefinite. You have to make this table. Fine. It changes to past indefinite. When does these rules apply? Can anyone tell me? Yesterday we finished on one major rule, that if reporting verb is in the past tense, clear, then these rules will be applicable. If reporting verb is in present or future, then these rules do not apply. Okay? Yes, you can do. So then one example of it. Do or does. Changes to did. Clear? Second is present continuous. It changes to past continuous. This is your revision only. You have been doing this in junior classes also. Like is, am, are. Yes. Changes to was, were. Depending upon the number of persons. Yesterday I asked you to bring colored chalks, beta. Nahi pade hue abhi. Not now, beta. Then after this, don't start any sort of discussion. Present perfect. Yes, it changes to past perfect. The one who's speaking will be telling us the example. Has or have changes to had. Then we have present perfect continuous. You'll be writing complete, beta. Present perfect continuous changes to past perfect continuous. Has been or have been. Yes, Peter. Okay, thank you. I'll be using after this. Yes, beta. Completed. Where is the duster? Udhar hi pada. Let me change some seats. हाँ जी आप उठ गए आप. Get up. आप जाओ. exchange seats. Don't disturb others. Yes, V1 plus ing is there. Clear? Then we will be writing other ones. Fifth is past indefinite. Have you better written, everyone? Fifth. Okay, I'm not going to erase the last two. You can write. That's it. So fifth one is past indefinite. Still I can hear noise. Past indefinite. Did plus V1. Fine. Now it changes to past perfect. Here you need to remember, earlier it was quite easier for you. That is had plus V3. Fine, past indefinite changes to past perfect. Past continuous. Changes to past perfect continuous. Was or were changes to had been. V1 plus ing will be there in both the cases. Fine. Was, were, V1 plus ing is there in past continuous. In past perfect continuous, had been plus V1 plus ing. That's why I have not written it same only. Two tables we'll be making. One is change of tenses and other one is change of pronouns. And then we'll come to the topic which is mentioned in your syllabus. Statements, questions, and imperative sentences. Seventh is, yes. Now, rather than writing the name of the tense, let's make it simpler as it is in your grammar book also. Will changes to would. Shall changes to should. I'll be taking a round to check. Those who are not writing, they can leave the class. Then we have another models. May changes to might. Can changes to could. Must beta, must remains must, or it can be changed into had to also. If must is written in the direct speech, it remains must in the indirect speech also, or you can change must into had to also. Yes, beta. May, might, can, could. No, I am not doing beta. Yes, must or had to, both will be accepted. Then we have in this norm beta, if they have written has to or have to or had to. In all these three cases, we will be changing it into had to only. Suppose had to is written, then had to remains had to only. If has to is written, then have to is written, had to remains unchanged. Clear? So this is the basic table. Yes. I'm saying whether has they have written or have, it will change into had. And if already had is written, then it remains unchanged. One more rule. Past perfect and past perfect continuous, both remain unchanged. Suppose had plus V3 is written, it will be had plus V3 only. If had been plus V1 plus ING is written, it will remain same. Clear? So you remember whenever had plus any verb will be there, it will be same. Clear? So you should remember this rule. Last boy. Something more important going on, you can also discuss here. Come here. You also sit properly. I need not name you again and again. Now, next table is change of pronouns. I'm going to erase it within a minute, complete it better. Now give the heading change of pronouns. We have done change of tenses. If you have not completed any tense, it is there in your grammar book also. But why I'm making you write here? Because grammar book has given n number of rules. You'll get confused. Clear? But this table is there. Now we'll be changing this tenses to change of pronouns. Yes, you stand up. Yes. Likh rahe ho to you are writing for yourself, not for me. Change of pronouns. I changes into me. You remains you. Let me finish. I'll be calling you here, those who are disturbing the class. He changes to him. She changes to her. We changes to us and they changes to them. Yes, is it clear to all sitting at home, children? Yes, beta, send me thumbs up and keep on noting down on your notebook. Clear? So after this, we'll directly come to your syllabus. These rules were basic rules which you need to know before changing any category of direct speech or indirect speech. So now in your syllabus, it is clearly mentioned reported statements. What sort of assertive sentences, interrogative sentences, and imperative sentences. Imperative sentences are those in which we make requests, command, order, and all. Fine. So we'll be starting straight away from that only. Conversion of assertive sentences. Clear? First category. Noted? That's it. Now you need not individually speak. Let's start with first type 1, write down in your syllabus, they have mentioned Dishant Folia, kindly behave. I must announce the names now. Yes, assertive sentences. Who will tell me? Let me tell you. Yes, stand up. Stand up, yes, you. Tell me, what do you mean by assertive sentences? And don't look here and there, you have to answer. What do you mean by assertive sentences? I guess that's why you are speaking, you already have the knowledge. Anybody can tell me? You know how to talk, but you don't know how to explain. Very good. Yes. Simple sentence. Sit down. Fine. So, clear? It is just a statement given in a sentence. It is not negative. It is not interrogative. Just one statement is given. You can in simple language say positive sentence. Fine? It will make it easier for you. Sit down, please. So if we don't have knowledge, we are coming to school just for the sake of talking, I do not understand. Misuse of mask to talk. So write down firstly, assertive sentences. I'll be giving you examples straight away. He said to me, one example write down. He said to me, comma, inverted comma, start. Your speech was heart-touching. Your speech was heart-touching. Sit down. Inverted comma, close this. So, this is our reporting verb. Fine. And this is our reported speech, which is in the inverted commas. Clear? So now we have to see how to convert it. This is our direct speech. Now we will be converting it into indirect speech. I'm using D and I for that. Clear? He told me. Whenever you will be saying said to changes into told. He told me that my speech was heart-touching. He told me, and you have to add conjunction that here. Now see, the person is talking to you. Your speech was marvelous. Your speech was heart-touching. So it will be that my speech was heart-touching. Is full stop. Second is now what I'm going to do, I'm not going to write on board. Second sentence I'll make you write. The person who speaks can write also. Come here. She said to him, she said to him, we'll be doing four sentences of each category to make it clarify. Fine, rules are same, whichever we have done. She said to him, your sister is a naughty girl. She said to him, comma, inverted comma, start. Your sister is a naughty girl. Full stop, comma, closes. Yes, you tell me the answer. Yes, sit down. She told him that his sister was a naughty girl. You have to be very particular about the pronouns. Boy or girl, sometimes we get confused and we write wrong pronoun. She told him that his sister was a naughty girl. Third is, yes, beta. Third sentence. Now you will raise hand for this also. The servant said to the master, the servant said to the master, comma, inverted comma, start. I have finished all my work. Yes. Had, fine. Rest of the, sit down. The servant replied to the master. You can also like this, fine? Because this is a reply. The servant replied to the master that he had finished all his work. It means it was a question to him. That's why we have used reply. Replied to the master, na? Because master is used here. The servant replied to the master that he had finished all his work. Next is, the teacher said to the students, the teacher said to the students, comma, inverted comma, start, I shall take you to Chandigarh tomorrow. I shall take you to Chandigarh tomorrow. Yes, beta. There is one mistake. Yes. It's not necessary that always if shall is there, then it will be into should only. We have to see the sentence otherwise. It can be changed into would also. Your turn is done. Yes, Princey. Next day is there. Yes, Princey. Yes, this is the correct answer. The teacher informed the students also. Told also will be accepted. The teacher informed the students that she would take them to Chandigarh the next day. Yes, beta. Next is second category, type 2. Interrogative. Interrogative sentences. Boys, I guess only this is the class where rather than teaching, I keep on pointing you out. So, very easy question. What do you mean by an interrogative sentence? Please stand up and tell me. Yes. The sentences which carry a question in them. Fine, sit down. So, better try to speak complete sentences. Every one of you, I'm talking to you all. We are so habitual of using Hindi and Punjabi. I'm not saying these languages are bad. Use it in your language periods. But when you are in English class, at least try to give complete answers. When you were in nursery, even then we kept on asking you. Till date, see, when I ask you, you give either one word answer or you start speaking in Hindi or Punjabi. Fine? And this is the way you behave. And these are the students. Then later on, they say, I'm going abroad. Fine? Without even learning English. Yes. Interrogative sentences which carry questions in them. how to convert. Now you need to write a few rules for this. Fine. Write down the reporting verb. This is the reporting verb in any of the sentence in direct speech. So rule number one in type two. In this, there were no rules. We have already done. In interrogative sentences, write down rule number one. The reporting verb is changed into asked, inquired, demanded, yes, etc. It depends upon the question. Fine. Reporting verb changes to asked, inquired, demanded, etc. Rule number one. Inquired, when a question is asked, inquiry is made. Second rule. Rule number two, very important. No conjunction is used. No conjunction is used in the reported speech. In the reported speech, if the question begins with, an interrogative word. What are the interrogative words? WH words. What, where, when, why? Fine. So when these words will be there in the reported speech, then you need not add any conjunction. That, if, whether, etc. You need not add any conjunction. Fine. So this is your rule number two. That is, no conjunction in the case of WH questions, fine? So examples are what, who, which, when, where, why, whose, whom, fine? All the WH questions plus one H. One H means how, fine? So whenever your reported speech will be carrying any of the questions, starting from these questions, then you will not add any conjunction, no conjunction rule. Then, very important third rule, change the questions into statements. Change the questions into statements. Questions do not remain questions in the reported speech. They become statements only, or they become assertive sentences, positive sentences in that way. Yes, boys. Lack of concentration means lack of learning. Then, beta, always put full stop in place of question mark. This is understood. Otherwise, if a question is changed into a statement, obviously, this is quite common that a question mark will change into statement or full stop. This should be there. Most of the students, they forget. And let me tell you, beta, your subjective test will be there in school. The term one, they have, board has mentioned term one. That is later on. So you will be appearing for multiple exams. Don't sit at home thinking, okay, we will be having objective and this is of very easy for us. So in school, you will be having paper and pen test. That is subjective. And when board will be sending, that will be objective. So both papers will be there. Better be prepared. That we will inform you later on. So now write down first example, beta. Interrogative sentences I need to finish this even if bell goes. So you want to waste your time? He said to her, had you displeased your brother? Yes, tell me the answer. Tanya is the first one to raise hand. What about others? Yes, Tanya, give the answer. Yes, inquired or asked, both are correct. Fine. He asked her if she had displeased her brother. Second is, he said to you, comma, inverted comma, start. Does she create a problem for you? Change it into indirect. Yes, Farina. Her nahi aayega beta, you remains you. If she created a problem for you, he asked you or he inquired you. He asked you if she created a problem for you. If is added in such sentences. If she, beta, one golden rule, you will see the statement. If the answer of the question can be in yes or no, then you will be using if. Like, see, if your brother created problem for you, either it will be yes or no. So in that case, if is applied. Clear? Chai likh ke rakh lo. That if answer of the question comes in yes or no, then we use if. Otherwise, wo jo WH wala. Fine. Next category is, yes, beta, let's start with WH wala example. He said to me, comma, inverted comma, start. Whom does she want to contact? One example of WH. He said to me, comma, inverted comma, start. Whom does she want to contact? He asked me whom she wanted to contact. And full stop. Yes, Bissam, you are right, Bitter. I'm going to end the meet. Bell has gone. Have a nice day.